Hey y'all, what's up? What's going on? Welcome back to my channel. For today's look, we're going to be using the new ABH Soft Glam Palette on my model here, Danielle. As you can see, it looks gorgeous. Very, very, very women of color friendly. So let's go ahead and jump into the tutorial. So I'm going to start with prepping the skin using the Mario Badescu Rose Water Spray. And then after that, we're going to go in with the Smashbox Photo Primer Oil. I absolutely love this oil for my clients to have a little bit more of a drier combination skin. It just helps all of the products glide onto the skin like butter. After that, we're going to do some light color correcting using my Stila Color Correcting Palette. And I'm just going to go in with the orange on the inner tear duct area. That way we can cancel out some of the darkness and keep that under eye area nice and bright. Then for concealer, we're going to go ahead and jump in with the Urban Decay Naked Weightless Skin Concealer. The shade that I'm using here for Danielle is in Dark Golding. I like to apply it, of course, with my little concealer brush by Real Techniques. I love it because it's very, very small and detailed. You can get in the nooks and crannies. And then we're going to blend it out with a sponge. Next up, we're going to go in. This is the new Cover FX Power Play Foundation. I am loving this foundation. So it's supposed to be a matte, but I know Cover FX, they do things a little bit more on the natural side. I think this is probably the first mattifying foundation that I have found that's probably going to look excellent on drier skin. It's not like suck your soul dry, but it gives you enough of a natural look without it being too dry or powdery looking. And then to set, we're going to take the MAC Mineralize Skin Finish. We're going to set up under the eyes, down the center of the nose, just hitting those areas where we concealed at. Next up, I'm going to take some Sasha Buttercup powder. I love this powder, especially for people of color, women of color. It just sets everything in place, and it's just perfect without giving a cast. And if you are worried about going in with getting a cast after, I always go over with the Mineralize Skin Finish just to throw back a little bit more color into the skin. And then we're going to bronze with CoverGirl Ebony Bronzer. Then after we get Danielle's bronzer on, we're gonna go in with a little bit of the MAC Mineralize Skin Finish in Sun Power. This is gonna give just enough color to the cheeks. All right, star of the show here. Soft Glam Palette, first shade we're gonna do is orange, burnt orange in the transition. After that, we're gonna hit up Sienna. I like Sienna a lot. I feel like it does go on a little bit darker than what I was expecting on the eye, so keep that in mind. It's not as dark as like Subculture eyeshadows. Those go on much darker, but just keep in mind it does go on a little bit darker. After that, I'm gonna grab my MAC 217 brush. I'm just gonna go ahead and just go right into the crease back and forth just to kind of deepen up that crease area for more dimension. For our next shade here, I love this shade. We're gonna take the shade Rose Pink, and I am using the ABH brush. ABH are the only eyeshadow palettes that come with brushes, and I like them. I switch over to my finger just to give it a little bit more intensity in certain areas. After that, I'm gonna switch over back to my MAC 217. We're gonna grab the shade Mulberry. This is a beautiful, deep, burgundy tone. I love it because it's going to instantly give you some dimension. It's going to make the eye look very, very nice and, you know, just sultry looking, and blending that out on the outer corner. And then I love Danielle's inner tear duct area. You guys know that's my thing. That's my little pop, my little trademark style there. So going in with the shade Glistening, just in the inner tear duct, just to kind of bring the look together and give you a little twinkle to the eye. And then we pop some lashes on. The lash glue's not quite dried yet. And that is going to complete this look. It's definitely my style, my aesthetic. You guys know I love natural glam. It's just enough, not too much. The skin looks like skin. A little bit of eye work going on. Awesome. All right, now time for my thoughts and opinions on the Soft Glam Palette. First of all, huge shout out to my client Danielle for being a model on my channel. I greatly, greatly, greatly appreciate it. As far as the Soft Glam Palette goes, you guys want to know, do I need it? Who's it for? Who is it going to look good on? I think this is a palette that's going to look good on everybody. My main motive for buying this palette was just simply because I was running out of my Modern Renaissance palette, and I thought to myself, hey, Let me get this one because you do have some repeat shades in here. I know Cypress Under, Umber, and Burnt Orange are in the Modern Renaissance palette. I'm out of those. So this palette for me came at a perfect time. I'm going to be using this palette more so in my on my clients for my bridal work. As soon as I saw this palette, I was like, this is a palette for the everyday woman, which is what my channel basically is, makeup for the everyday woman. Everyday woman, this is a palette for an artist that's doing bridal work, for prom work. This is the palette for someone that wants to have something that can wear in the daytime. They want to have something that they can wear in the nighttime. This is a palette that is easy for the beginner. You don't really have to sit there and look at it and analyze it and really think, okay, what kind of look am I going to make? I feel like the ABH Prism palette is a little bit trickier because I feel like the shades are kind of sporadic and random and it kind of forces you to think a little bit more. So if you're not a creative person, that palette's not for you. However, this one is easy, it makes sense, and the shades in this palette, as far as like the texture and the consistency of it, it is just like the Modern Renaissance palette. So if you're wondering, oh shoot, is this gonna be like another subculture? No, it's just like Modern Renaissance. The mattes do have a little bit of fallout, but it's not anything like subculture. I feel like that's just going to be a given as far as mattes go, especially with ABH, because their mattes are just a touch more pigmented than a lot of the other brands. And the shimmers, I do like the shimmers a lot. My rule of thumb is I always apply shimmers with my finger. That's with any brand. I just feel like it just gives it a little bit more pigment, a little bit more of a pop. Now, I do have this palette on my eyes right now. The look that I have on is, you know, it's a very neutral, very nighttime, va-va-voom, sultry kind of look. I have on my lid, I have on bronze on the outer corner, I have Nior, and then I have Sienna and Mulberry in my crease, and I really, really do like the way that this look came out. Again, like I was saying, this is a great palette for someone if you just want to have that one standard go-to palette, and you can do a daytime look and a nighttime look. Awesome. Another thing that I like about this palette is I didn't have to pull from any other palettes. I'm all about a palette where if I can just use the one palette and not have to pull and have like a whole collection of different eyeshadows just for one look, that's excellent to me, especially if I'm traveling, because when I travel, of course, you know, you gotta try to travel light, and sometimes, you know, if I pick one palette and it's like, oh crap, well, that one doesn't have a transition or that one doesn't have a brow bone, I feel like this works great for my brow bone highlight. I just went in with Burnt Orange, or you could do just a touch of Orange Soda, but I'd be careful with that one if you have deeper skin, because it might look a little ashy and chalky on you, all right? So that is going to complete my thoughts in my review and my tutorial on the ABH Soft Glam palette. Let me know down below if you are going to be trying it out. Also, I have on my face here the ABH bronzer here in mahogany. Wanted to give this another try. I just feel like it looks ashy on my skin. Please sound off down below what's your thoughts on it. And I have the Resi highlighter on. You guys know I'm not a highlighter person, however, I was like, you know what, let me start doing things differently, let me step outside of my box, let me stretch my creativity a little bit more. So I have this on. I really don't have an opinion on this yet. I've been testing it out for how many days now? I think I've been testing it out for about five or six days now. And my thoughts on it today, I don't like it. I feel like it looks ashy on camera because it's right up against that bronzer, and I feel like the bronzer looks really muddy and ashy on me. But whenever I've been wearing this without that bronzer on it, I've liked it. And then I like it on the body too. I think this is gonna be like more for me like a summertime banger to like kind of like put on my body to give me a little bit more glimmer and shine. But I'll definitely keep you guys posted on this. And then for my foundation today, I'm testing the new Dior. What's the name of that foundation? Hang on really quick. Dior Skin Forever Undercover Foundation. So that's the foundation that I'm testing out. This is my second day trying it on. It has not broken me out so far. I know three, four years ago, I tried the Dior Skin Star Foundation. I don't think they make that one anymore. Hands down, the most beautiful foundation I'd ever put on my skin, but it jacked my skin up. So this one, so far, so good. I do remember the Dior Skin Star being very, very, very high fragrance, so maybe that's what it was. This one has a slight fragrance to it, but I didn't notice anything that was too overwhelming. So we're testing that out here. I'll keep you guys posted on that. So down below, leave me your comments, your thoughts. Also want to say a huge thank you guys so much for coming through in the comments and liking my videos. Thank you for all your support. Thank you for all the comments on the Fiance Does My Video, Does My Makeup. That was one of those videos where I was kind of very nervous about uploading, just simply because I don't really, you know, get too deep into my personal my life here. I try to keep it strictly makeup, but however, it was very fun to do. Marillo enjoyed it. We had a good time. So thank you so much for your positive feedback on that as well. All right, guys. So I will see you in the next video. Peace.